So this is the silver wire reflex. What then is your ophthalmoscopic and fundoscopic finding? We say that we see characteristic AB changes. In slash, we say we've seen silver wiring. ऐसे ही है. बाकी हम क्या करें?
Silver wiring तो भी normal finding ना हुई.
Silver wiring exaggerated, attenuated जब हो जाए ना तब it's a normal finding. इतनी ज़्यादा नहीं होती. अब इस picture में जहाँ तक मुझे लग रहा है, it's not brown, it's whitish in appearance relatively. This is characteristically the silver wiring. नॉर्मल होती है वेसल्स में, लेकिन नॉर्मल आप देखें इट्स वेरी मिनिमल, इट्स माइल्ड, बहुत कम होती है वेसल्स में. लाइक ना जब आर्टरीज दे स्टिफन एंड दे स्टिफन एंड दे सॉर्ट ऑफ श्रिंक, तो दिस रिफ्लेक्स इज दिस रिफ्लेक्स बिकम स्ट्रेटर. फिर हम तब उसको क्या कहते हैं स्पेसिफिकली, दे अपीयर एट सिल्वर वायर्स एंड हेंस द टर्म सिल्वर वायरिंग. नॉर्मल रिफ्लेक्स होते हैं इट्स मिनिमल, it's not as much, not over the whole vessel. तो आगे हम क्या करेंगे?
एंजियोग्राम.
Hey, perfect. That's it. Yes, that is correct. I don't have an FFA of hypertensive retinopathy at the moment. But let's say, let's just suppose that in our FFA, we saw, let's say it was unremarkable. At the moment, it's unremarkable. What else can you do?
OCT?
OCT is also unremarkable at the moment. और हम क्या कर सकते हैं?
स्लिट एग्जामिनेशन हो गई थी?
कौन सी एग्जामिनेशन? स्लिट लैब एग्जामिनेशन पे ही हम ये सारी चीजें कर रहे हैं. व्हेन आई एम सेइंग फंडोस्कोपी, देयर आर टू वेज टू लुक एट द फंडस. वन इज डायरेक्ट ऑप्थाल्मोस्कोपी एंड द सेकंड इज स्लिट लैब एग्जामिनेशन. सो दिस इज स्लिट लैब एग्जामिनेशन जो अब हम हमने देखी है. एक और कोई इन्वेस्टिगेशन है आपके ज़हन में जो हमें करनी चाहिए?
नहीं
नहीं तो चलो, व्हाट इज योर डायग्नोसिस बेस्ड ऑन दिस हिस्ट्री एंड दीज फाइंडिंग्स?
Hypertensive retinopathy.
That's what the diagnosis
is.
Hypertensive retinopathy. अच्छा, अब hypertensive retinopathy, there are I think three classification systems of hypertensive retinopathy.
Four हैं.
चलो four होंगे, बिल्कुल. There are many. तो our diagnosis
is,
hypertensive retinopathy. पढ़ने दो ही हैं सिर्फ, जो we have to remember only two. ठीक है?
Okay.
Hypertensive retinopathy. One is the Keith, Wagner and Barker classification, abbreviated here as KWB. And the other is the clinical classification. जिसमें अभी किसी ने कहा था कि hypertension without sclerosis and all that. So remember that that is the clinical classification. Without sclerosis, hypertension with involuntary sclerosis, and hypertension with like the arteriolar sclerosis, malignant hypertension. Those are clinical classifications, and they, along with this examination, they include other findings of hypertension along with the age of the patient. Usually, is classification pe aapko MCQ nahi aata hota. Usually, I say. Usually, they ask for the grade according to the Keith, Wagner and Barker classification. So what is the Keith Wagner and Barker classification grade of this patient with these findings, AV changes and silver wiring?
4.
Someone said grade 4.
3.
Okay, 3. 2 bhi likh deta hu main, 1 bhi likh deta hu, 7. They're only 4 grades, right? Why is this grade 4?
Silver wire reflex.
Silver wire reflex. So somebody said silver wire. Aapne kahan se padhi ye classification?
Ye Jitoi se.
Yeah. Acha Jitoi mein yaad rakhna ki ye classification Jitoi mein theek likhi hui hai, Jogi mein galat likhi hui hai. Jogi mein it's a little bit different.
Okay.
So jo bhi jagah koi Jogi padha hai to usse bhi main kahunga ki either online you can search the classification ye Jitoi se aap dekh lo. मुझे जोगी वाली पर्सनली याद है एंड एज फार एज आई नो मैंने गलत लिखी है काफी जगह वो तो दिस इज नॉट ग्रेड 4 ठीक है इसमें एडिमा नहीं है बिल्कुल ठीक है ग्रेड 4 में देयर इज पैपिल एडिमा एंड देयर इज अ मैक्युलर स्टार सो व्हेनेवर यू थिंकिंग ग्रेड 4 हॉलमार्क ऑफ ग्रेड 4 इज पैपिल एडिमा ठीक है ऑलवेज रिमेंबर पैपिल एडिमा ग्रेड 4 Papilledema नहीं है, it's not grade 4. So this is not grade 4.
Grade 2?
This is grade 2. Why is this grade 2?
AV change crossing भी है, silver wire reflex भी है और NED. बाकी कुछ flame shape hemorrhages नहीं है.
बिल्कुल. So this patient he most likely has grade 2. So if he come again. Through all the classifications in grade 1 there is I think mild or moderate sclerosis only of the vessels sclerosis being hardening and shrinking of the vessels okay in grade 2 there are AV changes mild AV changes some AV changes I'm not sure jo toh isne kya likha hai so I'm not going to details in grade 3 this AV changes we can see cotton wool spots We can see frame-shaped hemorrhages. Okay. And in grade 4, along with all of these, we see macular edema and we see papillary edema. This is generally the 4 grades of Keith Wagner-Barker classification, and our patient he is grade 2. So how will we treat this patient?
Treat the cause.
What is the cause? Hypertension?
Hypertension.
So we will treat hypertension. Yes, he will be started on hypertensive drugs and his treatment will be done accordingly. So hypertensive retinopathy ki yahi treatment hai which you have to remember all this. Okay? The treatment is treatment of the hypertension. And secondly, prevention. What is prevention? प्रिवेंशन ये होगी कि व्हेन अ पर्सन इज डायग्नोस्ड तो उसको आप बताएंगे रेगुलर स्क्रीनिंग के लिए यू विल एडवाइज और काउंसिल द पेशेंट व्हेन ही इज फर्स्ट डायग्नोस्ड टू हैव रेगुलर फॉलोअप्स एंड रेगुलर चेकअप्स इफ ही इज डायग्नोस्ड एंड ही इफ द पर्सन इज अ न्यूली डायग्नोस्ड हाइपरटेंसिव देन ही विल बी एडवाइज रेगुलर स्क्रीनिंग ऑलराइट इस पॉइंट की समझ आएगी आपको
जी
ठीक है तो दिस वाज द कीथ वैगनर एंड बार्कर क्लासिफिकेशन राइट अगर हम दूसरी क्लासिफिकेशन करें द क्लिनिकल क्लासिफिकेशन तो व्हाट वुड बी द क्लिनिकल डिजीज क्लिनिकल क्लासिफिकेशन के लिहाज से क्लिनिकल क्लासिफिकेशन किसी ने पढ़ी है
जी पढ़ी थी
क्या याद है इसमें से कौन सा ग्रेड होना चाहिए पेशेंट का
विद इनवॉलंटरी स्क्लेरोसिस क्योंकि वो ओल्डर पेशेंट्स में भी होता है उसमें एवी चेंजेस भी हैं
ठीक है दैट इज गुड दिस इज हाइपरटेंशन विद इनवॉलंटरी नहीं है इट्स इनवॉल्यूशनरी ठीक है इट मींस रिगार्डिंग द एज इनवॉल्यूशनरी स्क्लेरोसिस Sclerosis that is happening with age. जो clinical classification है, it's very simple. Okay? There's hypertension in old people, It's called hypertensive retinopathy in old people. It's called hypertension with involutionary sclerosis. There is hypertension in young patient. It's called without sclerosis. Then there's severe hypertension in young patients. It's called hypertension with arteriolar sclerosis. And if there is rapid production of hypertension without the relatively young arteries and still, and there is rapid production, then it's called malignant hypertension. You have to remember these grades always. The Keith, Wagner and Barker classification, जो जोगी और जितोई में है, I think उसमें grade 2 और 3 में थोड़ी सी science का difference आ जाता है. बाकी they're same, but I would still recommend कि आप जितोई से करें, जोगी वाले grades नहीं याद करें, even though they look simple. Four grades of Keith, Wagner and Barker classification and the four types of clinical hypertension. Hypertension without cirrhosis, hypertension with involutionary cirrhosis. Involution means changes which occur with age. Hypertension with arteriolar sclerosis and malignant hypertension. Okay? So this was our management of this patient. So let's say there's another case. Okay, we found the rest is the same. His visual acuity is 6/20. His BP is 150/85. Characteristic ophthalmoscopic and fundoscopy. Okay. When we do the fundoscopy, is what we see.
Cotton wool spots.
Cotton wool spots कौन से हैं? Which arrow indicates the cotton wool spots?
Black. जो white वाला.
White वाला. Okay. Someone said white, and someone said black. So the cotton wool spots.
White spots.
ठीक है, white spots. So these are cotton wool spots. जो इन black arrow को point कर रहा है. These are cotton wool. Cotton wool spots होते क्या?
Nerve damage.
ठीक है. Remember that cotton wool spots are due to damage of the nerve axons. And the axons, they cannot transport material between the dendrites and the cell nerve bodies. There is accumulation of material. This is clinically manifested as cotton wool spots because they appear like cotton wool and they are movable. What is this white arrow?
Hemorrhage.
Flame shape. This is flame shape hemorrhage. That is correct. There are many types of hemorrhages in the retina. This is flame shaped hemorrhage. Is chhod dein, disregard this arrow for me. What does this box indicate? Isme kya hota?
AV malformation.
AV malformation nahi kahenge. These are characteristic AV changes. AV malformation means that something is wrong in the original formation on the original construction of these vessels. Theek hai? At points towards or this tells us there's a genetic or embryological or developmental abnormality. This is not the case. These are AV malformations, AV changes. You can see there's a copper wiring. Okay, it's appearing brown and the reflex is greater than in other parts. Okay, baki vessels will be here, thoda bahut. Over here you can see the copper wiring. Either be here. But these vessels, they are relatively unaffected. The other vessels, just right, this part is unaffected, but again here, there it is, right? So one is the characteristic copper wiring, and what else?
S-shaped vein leading.
Okay, there is nipping, slight nipping of the vein, which we call tensine, and there's an S-shaped deviation. Okay, S-shaped deviation of the vein. What is this sign called?
Shallow sign.
I don't know the
pronunciation, but let's call it saline. Okay, this is saline. This is S-shaped deviation of the vein at the AV crossing. Okay, so abhi tak humne two signs dekhe hai. One we saw gun sign, which was nipping, which which is not as evident to clear over here, but it, there is some slight nipping. Then we said saw cellucine, which is S-shaped deviation. So, आगे हम क्या करेंगे? Now, ophthalmoscopic and fundoscopy, we found AB changes. We saw flame-shaped hemorrhages. We saw cotton wool spots. Hmm. And we saw, what else did we see? We saw
cellucine.
Both of AB changes, we have written. AB changes, we have written. AB changes, we have written. That's all. आगे हम क्या करेंगे?
अब treatment पे move कर देंगे.
चलो treatment की तरफ आ देंगे. So what is the grade of this patient? What is your diagnosis?
Grade 3.
According to Kate Wagner, grade 3.
Kate Wagner classification grade 3. Why is this grade 3?
Flame-shaped
hemorrhages and cotton wool spots, flame-shaped hemorrhages in AV changes. And there is no papular edema, there is no macular edema. Macular edema or papular edema, if we don't have any eyes, do you think there's an investigation we should do? Rule out, if we don't have any eyes. OCT, do
it.
OCT mein, when we discussed OCT in our first lecture last time around, we saw that normal retina should look like this. Is colors mein, colors ye honge, but it should look like something like this. So if there is edema, so, this is not basically hypertensive edema, this is cystoid macular edema. It's a different, more or less different disease. Lekin hota aise hi hai. There's fluid in the layers of the retina. It is not being hosted there. The OCT may, the norm, normal gene is an energy. If we look at the macula and the fovea, or how may isra nazrai, anything signifying fluid, so that means that macular edema is present. If macular edema aa jayega, so that is great. So this is grade 3 hypertension. And the treatment will be the same. That treatment, obviously.
Treat the cause.
Hypertension hum treat karenge, manage karenge. And since this is not a newly diagnosed patient, we will advise him regular follow-ups and checkups and report if he suffers from any other complication or symptoms. So, I'm going to take care of now before we move on to diabetic retinopathy. This is a good image of the retina in which we can see the general changes that occur in grade 3 to 4. One by one. These are cotton wool spots. We saw them in the last picture. Generalized arteriolar attenuation, which we term as sclerosis. You can see that this means that the arteries, they are shrinking, they are decreasing in size. And the overall central reflex of them is increasing. Arterioles are attenuated, they are shrinking, getting smaller in size. This is a characteristic change jo thoda sa blur ho gaya isme. But if I say that there's an S-shaped deviation over here, then what sign is this?
Cellucine,
right? And over here, again, even though it's not clear enough, but we can see that there is slight nipping. Nipping ho rahi hai na? Vena na ke collapse kar rahi hai. ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे इसके ऊपर कोई चीज पड़ी हुई है जोर से और ह्यूमन वेन का कोलैप्स कह रहा है. दिस इज कॉल्ड द मार्कस कंसाइन और कंसाइन. सो दीस टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक एवी चेंजेस. देन अगेन वी हैव फोकल आर्टेरियोलर एटेन्यूएशन. द वेसल आर्टरी ओवर हियर इज स्लाइटली श्रिंक. इसमें इतना क्लियर नहीं है इस पिक्चर में, बट इफ यू लुक क्लोजली इट्स स्पेसिफिक जगह पे ना इट्स श्रिंक और कंस्ट्रिक्टेड. व्हाट Now generally look at this. You can see macular star pe aate hain abhi. We have 2 minutes. So, you can see that cotton wool spots थे ही थे. There is something else inside this picture too. Vessels के distribution पे there are these whitish deposits. Okay. Okay, around the retina. These they are hard exudates. ये जो आपको नजर आ रहे हैं. If compare this picture, the vessels of this picture, the vessels of this picture, in this case, don't you think that something is rather whitish in the background?
Yes.
These are hard exudates. हम clinically इनको differentiate करेंगे cotton wool से और hard exudates को आपस में, because during slit lamp examination. हम पेशेंट को कहते हैं कि अपनी आंखें ऊपर नीचे करें, दाएं बाएं करें, इन ऑर्डर टू चेक वेदर दीज आर मोबाइल और इमोबाइल. द कॉटन वूल स्पॉट्स दे शेप दे चेंज एंड दे टेंड टू बी मोबाइल, व्हेयरएज़ द हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स दे आर इमोबाइल. दीज आर इमोबाइल इन द मेंटेन देयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन शेप, दीज आर हार्ड एक्सुडेट्स. एंड फाइनली अ थिंग व्हिच इज फाउंड इन ग्रेड 4 अलोंग विद पैपिलेडीमा, दिस इज मैक्युलर स्टार. थोड़ा सा इसको दूर से देखना पड़ेगा. डू यू थिंक दैट दिस अ स्टार शेप अपीयरेंस और अ पैटर्न फॉर्मिंग इन दिस पिक्चर? स्पोक्स थोड़े से नजर आ रहे हैं बाहर निकलते हुए आपको?
जी
नहीं,
नहीं नजर आ रहे, कुछ को नजर आ रहे हैं.
ये
थोड़ी सी पिक्चर जो है ना वो लो रेजोल्यूशन में डालती है. बेसिकली दिस इज मैक्युलर स्टार. मैक्युलर स्टार क्या होता है? देयर इज एक्युमुलेशन ऑफ हार्ड